Hey guys, it's Melanie. Happy Sunday. So today I'm going to be giving you a review of the Farmstand Strawberry 4-Wick Candle. So this one is obviously new for this spring and summer. I did decide to go ahead and put the Homeworx original strawberry fruit basket behind the candle because the drop-in inserts that came with that particular product are actually the exact same fragrance as the newer Farmstand Strawberry 4-Wick from this year. So I was really excited that Harry decided to go ahead and put this into the larger candle format because this is honestly my favorite, like most favorite strawberry scent that I have ever smelled. It is so good, you guys. We'll talk about the scent here in a minute, but I did want to reassure you that if you really loved the fragrance of the strawberry fruit basket from last summer, and you wanted more of that, you will find the exact same blend in this 4-Wick format here, so which is really exciting. In terms of packaging for this collection, I thought it was really cute. I do like when Harry does the scalloped lids, and this particular collection, which by the way also has the Farmstand peaches, which I will be doing a review of probably next Sunday. So it has the Farmstand peach as well as the Farmstand cherry. So I will link all three of those down below. And actually the strawberry fruit basket is also still available. So if you like the look of that for decor purposes, I would definitely recommend picking that up only because those are currently being clearanced out. So once they're gone, I don't think those are going to come back again, which is a major bummer. I have talked about how I am really going to miss the drop-in candle inserts that come with these once I finish them. So the good thing is you can use the fruit baskets for decor, but if you want them, I'll go ahead and link them down below as well. They're also on reduced shipping and handling, I believe, on top of like the clearance price. So if you want them, I would snag them up. But back to the packaging here. So you've got some cute cut up strawberries. You've got that white scalloped lid, and you've got like a kind of like powder blue and white striped motif on the label as well. And it is a wraparound, so it goes the whole way around. Okay, so this is my third burn, and I have to say I'm really impressed with how the spring candles are performing for me so far. I'm having really great luck. The wicks that Harry used on this particular one are kind of, I would say, like bendy wicks. They tend to like lean over a little bit, but they never actually like fall into the wax, if that makes sense. I'm gonna see if I can give you guys a view here. So they don't form like huge mushroom tops on them, but they certainly do need the slightest bit of trimming before you relight. Do not take too much off, because if you cut these wicks too short, then you could deal with some performance issues. So I would recommend, if you don't have them already, getting a pair of cuticle scissors from the drugstore, like in the nail care section, and just trim like the tiniest bit off before you relight. Let's talk about the fragrance description, and I'll tell you what I get from it, and then I'll tell you about like the strength and throw of this particular format, because that is actually better than the fruit basket. So the description that is on the website here says farm fresh strawberries, red raspberries, currants, lemon zest, and crystallized sugar. So basically what you are getting from this is a very sweet, very juicy, slightly tart, predominantly strawberry scent. I do think that the raspberry note is definitely in there. Raspberry has, it also has kind of a sweet scent to my nose, but it's not as sweet as the strawberry. You can really tell where that crystallized sugar comes into play. This is definitely something that is not cloyingly sweet, but it's a very sweet scent. If you don't typically go for gourmand scents because you don't like things that are like sweet, I don't know that you would care for this one, but I think if you love fruit scents, especially strawberry, this is gonna be fantastic for you. As far as the currants go, my nose does not pick up a currant note in this at all. And I do see where you could get just a tiny hint of that like lemon, but it doesn't smell like lemon zest to me. It, 'cause that tends to have a slight bitterness. This smells more like fresh squeezed lemon juice. And not a lot, you know, like if you were to like cut up apples or fruit in the summertime and you wanted to stop them from browning, you just put like a little bit of lemon juice over top. It kind of smells like that. But that crystallized sugar note is definitely there, and it makes that already sweet strawberry a little bit sweeter in addition. So it's beautiful, you guys. It is so very similar, if not the exact same as the original one behind the candle there. The performance though, there's a difference. So we all know that the fruit baskets, the wicks really tended to kind of lean and tilt and shift. It's almost like the wicks were just far too thin for the soft wax that was used with the strawberry fruit baskets. That is not an issue with this. I'm not experiencing any wick movement. The wicks are very different. I also find that with these different wicks, I am getting a much better strength and throw from the scent. So I would put the strength of this one at a pretty solid 7. Do I wish it was a little bit stronger? I kind of do, because I just love this type of scent so much. But I think it's good for what it is. The throw on this for me is also right around like 7, 7.5. I can most definitely smell it in the vast majority of the downstairs of my house. Right now I am burning this in my entryway, on my entry table, and I have really good airflow in this house, but especially in this particular area right here, because this is kind of like the central point in the house, and the stairway goes all the way up. It's like a very open ceiling here, and this travels to the back of the house. It also travels to the vast majority of the downstairs of the house. I do live in a 4,000 square foot house, and this fills it when it's in this location. However, when I put it in my kitchen, it mostly just scents the downstairs of the house, which I'm fine with. As long as a candle is noticeable throughout like either the upstairs or the downstairs of the house, I'm good with that. Like that makes me happy. So with all that being said, will I repurchase this? Oh yeah. Absolutely, 100%. I will be getting backups of this. I am waiting to buy my backups, however, on a free shipping weekend. My hope is that possibly Memorial Day weekend, there will be some free shipping. And when that comes around, I will stock up, because this is something that I want to be smelling all summer long. This combines really nicely, by the way, with other fruit scented candles from Homeworx. So you'll be seeing another review after this video of another new candle. I'll let you guys kind of guess which one that is, but you should definitely stay tuned for the next video. I'll be uploading that today as well, because I want to get these reviews out as quickly as possible. I do believe that Homeworx is extending the shipping into the summer a little bit this year, so I want to say that the cutoff is going to be on June 15th. those of you that are familiar with what happens with Homeworx, Harry doesn't ship the candles during like the height of the summer heat. So typically like the end of May is when he has done the cutoff for the last orders going out from the QVC warehouses. However, this year it's being extended to the 15th of June. So my hope is that there are one or two free shipping periods during that time, because I will certainly need to stock up on some summer scents. I have been going through my Homeworx candles because I just enjoy burning them so much. So I'll need just a few more for kind of my backup stash. But anyway, if you picked up the Farmstand Strawberry, let me know what your thoughts are. How do you think it compares to the fruit basket from last year? Definitely let me know. I really appreciate you guys taking the time to watch. If you're new, please subscribe. And like I said, stay tuned for the next video, which I will upload right after this one. So we'll be talking about some more fruity things. So, all right, thank you guys, and I'll see you soon.